What's going on, guys? It's Sam, and today I'm going to show you how to make an easy motion graphics title in Premiere Pro. In this video, you'll learn how to create motion graphics titles, how to manipulate that title, and how to use that title all in Adobe Premiere Pro.
That's good.
Alright guys, so let's go ahead and dive in. So I want to show you how to make that motion graphics title. We're going to be using the Essential Graphics panel, and I have my sequence open right now. It's the motion graphics title demo, and also we're going to need the Essential Graphics panel. So if you don't have it, you can go to Window and then go down to Essential Graphics, okay? So here I have Essential Graphics open. It's blank. My sequence is blank. There's nothing. And what I can do is I can create a new graphic by just hitting this little new layer button. And then let's select rectangle, okay? So now that we have a rectangle, I'm gonna go ahead and expand it out and make it take up all of the space here. Also in the meantime, I'm gonna drop in some footage. So now that I got my footage, I'm gonna move the graphic over. I have this shape, this big white shape, because I expanded the rectangle out. I'm going to just call this box one, and then I'm also going to duplicate this twice, okay? I'm gonna call these box two and three. Okay, so I have three boxes now. They're all the same color. They're all the same size. And I'm gonna animate these boxes to bring up this title card that we're trying to create. So in order to animate, we're gonna hop into effect controls with this graphic still selected. And you'll notice all the shapes and boxes here in the left panel up top. So let's turn off box two and three, and let's just focus on box one. And all I wanna do is animate the position, okay? So let's move my playhead all the way to the beginning of the graphic. And then let me go ahead and click on position. And then let me scoot forward a little bit, put another keyframe, and then let's go ahead and go back to the first one and adjust the first one. Just scoot it off screen, just like that, okay? And what I wanna do is I wanna make sure I'm easing the animation in. So when I play it, it's just kind of basic, but I want to right click on this keyframe and ease that in. So now I'm gonna repeat the steps for box two and three, but I'm gonna make them a little offset. So if we turn off box one and turn on box two, I'm going to change the color here. I'm gonna make it kind of like a blue, maybe like a, yeah, light blue. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna scroll down in effect controls, and I'm gonna go to that first keyframe. I'm gonna hold shift and press it twice, because that's how much time I want to pass before this next box starts animating. So now let's turn box one back on, copy the position of box one, turn box one off. And let's go ahead and click on box two and paste that in. So it pastes it in on the position keyframe for box two, and it's the same duration of animation. So when we play this back with box two and box one open, you'll see we got a white and a blue one chasing each other, okay? So let's do the same for box three. Hold shift, press right twice, because that's when I want box three to start animating. And then let's go ahead and paste in that same position. So now that we have three boxes, all with the same animation at different times throughout, let's see what it looks like. Beautiful, okay, let's turn this top box into kind of like a darker blue. Look at that. Now I also want to make these boxes disappear at the end of the graphic. So let's go ahead and move our playhead down over here, and let's start with box one, okay? So we're gonna make box one. We're gonna make it start here. I'm gonna right click and change this keyframe to linear. And before I continue, I'm gonna scroll up and turn off box two and three, because I just wanna see box one. And now I'm gonna scoot the position for this new playhead position to add the keyframe and scoot it all the way off. Okay? And then I'm gonna have this ease in. So now I'm gonna drag these two keyframes and put them at the very end of the effect controls panel. And at the end of the graphic, I'm gonna scroll up. Also, copy and paste these two keyframes. Let's scroll up. I'm going to hold shift and line my mouse up with this bottom keyframe for box number one. I'm going to turn off box number one, turn on box number two, click on box number two, hold shift, go to the left twice, and paste it. Okay? So you can see these keyframes pasted in. I'm going to do the same for box three. Hold shift, go left number two, and paste it. There you go. So now let's see what we did. Turn on all the boxes. There it goes, we got a blue screen, and it should go away now. Look at that. Just a simple little matte transition with three layers. It looks pretty nice, it's fairly unique. You can change the colors. Okay, so now let's go ahead and add the text, okay? So right when this blue fills up, that's when I want the text to pop on. So I'm gonna click inside the graphic, go back to the Essential Graphics panel, hit that new layer button, and let's add some text, okay? So I'm just gonna scoot this text over. Let's just kind of put it in the middle. If it's not snapping in your program monitor, you can hit this wrench right here, click on snap in program monitor, So with the text selected, I'm gonna make sure that it's centered. Okay, this one's just gonna be our title or number if you wanna do a countdown or something. 200 size. Let's just kinda scoot this up and maybe put the bottom of it right at the center line of the program monitor. And then let's go ahead and duplicate this text. Okay, so now we got two titles. So let's edit this text and let's do like insert subtext in this area. I'm gonna bring this text back down to 100 size font and put it, you know, right at the bottom of the title. Okay, so now when we look at our graphic and I play it, the text is there immediately. I want the text to show up when the blue is here, right? I don't want it to be there while it's transitioning. So let's go ahead and make that happen. So right when the blue appears, let's go inside of effect controls and go to our title and let's, you know, minimize everything else. Open the title, hit the mask box. Okay, so now all we can see is whatever's in this mask. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drag these points out all the way to fill out the entire top half. Okay, so whatever text you want to put in here, you can customize it, but it's about the top half. Okay, it's not a perfect line, but that's all right. So now I want to make sure that the text starts revealing at this point, right when the blue takes up the full screen. So I'm going to hit the mask path and I'm just going to move my playhead over a little bit, and then I'm going to hit the mask again and then hit that keyframe and then go back to the original keyframe. Click on the mask to bring it up and then just kind of drag the mask over so that it reveals the text. Okay, so now when we play this, bam, the text gets revealed. Let me turn off the audio here. Okay, so now the text is getting revealed and I also want it to go away right when the blue starts moving again. Okay, so when the blue starts moving, I want to make sure it's gone. So I'm going to set a keyframe there and then a keyframe here. Go to the end keyframe, hit the mask, and then pull the mask off again so that it disappears, okay? So now the subtext is still there, but the title swipes on and also swipes off. So now that our title is revealing, let's make sure our subtext does the same thing, okay? So let's go back into the graphic, still in effect controls. Let's line up our playhead with where the mask begins in the title, and let's minimize the title, and let's go to the subtext. And let's create the mask here. So let's create that box. And we're going to repeat it. We're going to make it disappear. So I'm holding shift. That should be where the next keyframe is. Yes, it is. Let's hit that keyframe, hold shift again, go to the next keyframe, click on the mask, pull it back off. All right, so let's play it. Bam, look at that. It's a great title card to use in any video. You can customize the colors. You can also customize when the masks animate. You'll just have to go inside the effect controls after you download the template that's available. As always, I have this animation available as a template that you can download by clicking the link. It's like the first line in the description. So you can click right there, just type in your email and your name and it'll be sent right to your inbox and you can use the motion graphics template. Also, you'll notice down below that there's a sign up link for the upcoming YouTube Motion Graphics Academy. You can sign up to get on the pre-sale early bird list. You can get access before everyone else. So sign up there and also be sure to check out the link for setting up a one-on-one tutoring session with me as well. All those links are down below. And the last thing I want to leave you with is the next video that I think you should watch, and it is on how to create a motion graphics intro. So please check that out. I know you'll love it. And it's just like this. There's a template available over there too. So go give that a watch and I'll see you there.